Hello, hello. D. Calvin. Ah, people. Is it kind of early to hate this early in the morning? Yes, no? All right. Let's get started. I've got paper over here. Whoa. Hello, got Kirihiko in the house. Pandemus, Queen City Amusement, Steve Calvin, Action Detective 11, Johnny Boy, R, Twin 1-2, Crispy Egg Roll, got two mods in the house. We'll see if PK makes it. He was up pretty late last night. Biliasa, hello. Kirihiko, right there. 26 months, I know, you should get a medal. Spengy G, Bihava. Guard, what it do? Good question. That's a good question, just life in general. What it do? Turbo Lips. All right, let's get started. I only have like an hour and a half. I thought I had 2 hours, but it's just an hour and a half. Son celebrates his 6th birthday today, so very excited. I think it's also Dan DiDio's birthday too. Anyway. Trippy, right? So I have an assignment today. I am going to draw something called Genlock. It's sort of a original anime that's produced by Rooster Teeth in Austin, Texas. Series that's come out called Genlock, voiced and produced by Michael B. Jordan. Set in a dystopian future Earth where an international coalition known as the Polity fights a hostile, autocratic, invading force known as the Union. The Union. The show follows the Genlock program and its members who participate in the development and testing of an experimental technology which allows for individuals with unique mental makeups to have their minds uploaded to giant suits of mecha armor. Okay. I usually, when I do stuff like this, I find visual reference, of course. But I also like to print it out. Let's do this. It's a trail. For those of you doing the same assignment, I just loaded up the official trailer for Genlock, just watching it real quick. Hey, Nick Briss, Geo, my dude. Looks pretty badass. Thank you for subbing, Benfart. So, thank Emma Tane, BJ Kicks, Tim Beksh, The Mass Crisis, MTELUS1, D. Calvin, all for subbing, D. Calvin for gifting the sub to Tim Beksh. Wow. So in watching this trailer, there's a lot of design work. And I'm going to have to do a couple frame grabs here. Badass, though. Sure, I've got that. So there are three robots here. Make sure I have the right one. That's a cool shot right there. So I'm basically going through the trailer and picking out images. That's a real clean one of the villain. Three heroes, I'm wondering. Let me just pull reference. Let's see. Oh, yeah, that's a pretty cool shot. Wow. The whole Vanguard team. That's a badass image. There's the there's the cover right there. It's a, wow, that's a pretty cool looking design. It's just a lot easier to refer to when it's printed out rather than looking at a screen for me, at least. If I were working digitally, I would just pull this reference into the desktop, of course. But I'm not. I'm doing it the old analog way. Bear with me 1 second. There we go. That's the last thing I'm going to do. All right, what do we have going on? Let's get caught up. very quickly, let's acknowledge the people that make the stream a reality. It's all the supporters out there. So Kanger Banger has cheered 500 bits. Happy Sunday. Thank you, Kanger Banger. Past Mirai has resubbed and has a question. Go ahead and just ask it. Plate Riot, Beliasa, Telejanis, Telehanis, Eddie Biedemann, When It Rains, have all subbed via Prime or on their own. I've done it for significant amounts of time. So thank you for the support. Daniel J. Bosco, thank you very much for the cheer and the 612. Love this Batman 612 cover flip. Oh, that was a commission. It was a private commission. Strixian, hello. Thanks for resubbing. Chunk Style 3030, Twin 12 Action, Dexstar 671, Jeremy L. Joe, MTELUS 1, Bamfart, I've already mentioned that, MTAIN 1, BJ Kicks, Tim Baksh, Mass Crisis, D. Calvin, 22 Bonilla, Cupcakes, Ariane, Mansage, Kirihiko, have all subbed. Thank you very much. Right Now and Later has resubbed for 19 months as well. Thank you. All right, let's get going. There's nothing going on. Let me get the reference. I'll be right back. It would help if I had the mic on. No sound. There was nothing important that I said, don't worry. Yeah. I'm just thinking shapes now. Never mind you characters. Given how large that main room. But I do also like, I feel like there's one cover here to be had of, given what they did with my Ruby cover, they didn't put the trade dress on it. So I'm thinking that I can move this down even further. While we're on the subject of birthdays, it's my son's birthday today. Do you guys remember what your favorite birthday of all time? How old you were and what you did that made it so? Very quickly, don't write a whole novel. But just curious what sticks with people. Of these jets. Make the sound effect. That's just part of it. And maybe there's no jet here because I'm going to have people. I'm going to have like these robots though. Oh, you know, I will have people. I'll have people like they're fighting. Oh, the buildings are collapsing. It'd be chill if we could see what you were drawing. It's just a layout. Let's see what else. This is what I've drawn. The stream is for drawing? Or maybe. What do we got going on? Catch up on these favorite memories. Rex Luxon, do you know if it's possible to be a comic book artist for DC if you don't live in the US? Yeah, a lot of our talent live abroad. Brazil, Spain, Philippines, France, everywhere. Eddie Biederman, 40. My wife had an amazing surprise party for me and my family. That's cool. Action Detective 11. Thank you, Spicy Pickle 726. Now, I drew this robot pretty large, but I'm not going to do it that large because I do need to fit in some other elements. So let's just go ahead and do a small one here. Shrink it down a little bit. Okay, so that's the double arm there. No. trying to get the simplest shapes. There's a lot of complexity, obviously, to the armor, but you got to think of just like the torso, thigh, just like it's a human skeleton. It's a kneecap there. See that? Wigs 1, 3, 4. I make it look easy. Yeah, I've just been doing it a lot. If you do it over and over, it gets easier and easier. Interesting how you don't pick up the pencil to lay out. Is it all one line? I don't know. Here's the other robot. They're making face-to-face contact. It's critical. And, oh, man. These mech things. So complicated. Once you figure out the secret, it's a lot of fun, I would imagine. Units come more forward. Looks like I've got some ears. Okay. Truck style 3030. How do I change the carburetor in a 78 Dodge pickup? I think you Google it. DIY. Change carburetor 78 Dodge pickup, and then go to the hardware store. They'll tell you they have to custom order the piece. You have to wait a long period of time. I think that should be pretty easy. Can you tell us not to give up? Do not give up. Good morning, Vic Rattlehead 78. Peter Hexenhammer. My facial bone structure is similar to Arnold Schwarzenegger's. Odart. O-D-A-R-R-T. I can't describe. It's kind of confidential. I could talk in general. There's a lot of creative work. Scripts that have to be read. Presentations that have to be worked on. Spreadsheets that have to be vetted. decisions that have to be made. There's a stereotypical sort of normal business day. Casey Gesk, hey. That's a building. It's collapsing. This is like a little small personal mech. Jet. Jet there. It just seems very convenient that it just fits that space. Okay, so this is a collapsing structure. Some other buildings here. And I'll put the jets over here. 1, 2, 3, and then maybe 1, 2. If I put the jets, do I want to put them in a graphical design thing like this? Kind of like that. Jets here, I can do something kind of similar. It's too flat, they should go into the space more. Just been used to drawing on 9 by 12 paper. So when I go to this larger board, it's kind of, excuse me, I'm finding it. It's too large for the space, so it's kind of falling all over. All right, so that's my layout. Cover. I'm going to pencil and ink it myself. Thank you very much, Queen City Amusements. So yeah, it's where are these pictures? Hey, good morning, Superhero Summer Art. So now I just have this eraser, a small white eraser. I erase it flat, parallel to the board, not at an angle, not down, flat. Just like that. Let me just move the camera. It got bumped. There we go. There we All right, since I'm inking it, I'm not going to worry about the shadow so much. I want to get all the structure at this point. So, let's thank you, Pink Floyd 95. Okay. Tricky, this villain. I think I kind of know how the head is structured, but it's hard to tell from just these two images. Let me look at some more. Frame grab, so it's a little blurry. Soft focus to it all. You know what? Let's see something here. Oh, good idea. There. Pretty sure they sent me a reference. Ba-da-ba-da. Da-da. Okay. That's a pretty clean shot. I'm looking at a robot design that does not look like this robot. Here we go. All right, I'm looking at a trailer. It's moving around so fast. Oh. That's what I have to do. Fantastic. God, I'm trying to capture this angle. So tricky. The camera's just moving around so much. All right, it looks like I had a guess. Sort of a triangular head. Things like that. And then a red eye here. I want to make sure. Right. Someone on Twitter has posted something. Huh, I cannot tell. The one thing I think I can tell, though, is that the designs are fairly as sort of angular as they are. I'm getting that they're a little more organic in their, you know, just kind of like random spikes and things like that pop up. Right, they're asymmetries. Thing with this triangular thing is trying to figure out what the face is. I think it goes like this. Sort of like a bow of a ship. This thing goes here. But now that's too big for the size of the robot, so I gotta shrink it all down. That. Some sort of angular element. I'm trying to use a 2D image and create a 3D model in my head. And then there's two arms that come out of it. Make sure I'm in the frame here, guys. Sorry if I'm not. I haven't streamed in a while. PJ Bicer. Hello. Yeah, it's what I'm drawing professionally for like a book or you're gonna be drawn for like hours, like get all too amped and too crazy, you're just gonna run out of steam. It's like a long session of drawing that it's kind of future here. Take a break and celebrate my son's birthday. I'm drawing in the chat window. I'm drawing down here. Make sure I'm just trying to stream. Thinking like some big sweeping sort of Walt Simonson kind of shapes. I had that other arm back here, but I don't like it. It makes it look flat. So I think here. And what happens if it grabs a building by the side? So it's actually responsible for this. Now, the other robot here. Also gonna make sure that the head is the appropriate size to give the mech proper proportions. And then he's got like actually kind of turn and towards that person's face. And then his other arm put out here, coming up over here, although it's got a gun. This has like a blaster or something, but let's just not do that for now. Let's see what happens if I just stick with this. Let's do it so that the hand is there. The building is crumbling this way. Knocking, like kind of a domino effect to other. Including this one that's happening in the foreground here. Okay. Pretty good with it, I think. Let me get a little more detail on this guy. Very interesting helmet. A lot of parts here, but essentially, it's like a front area. And that leads to a brow. Okay. And then that. Something like that. I guess Baltimore's next weekend. Second to last show of the year. And you guys go to LA Comic Con? Happening now, I think, right? Extrapolate a lot. Then this leg thing would require. Very high-tech gloves. This creature is like very cybernetic. So the trick to this, like I'm literally using two pieces of reference, is I have to kind of fill in the rest and then kind of think about like what would be logical. There's parts of it that I just do not have insight over. Per se. But you can see this robot, can't you? I'm just wondering if this should all be like just moved over a little bit. You know, I could do that without, I just push this one back. A little room here. So, go like this. This guy. Just about moving everything else back a little bit. And it kind of centers the composition a little bit more. I guess the sense that basically how the fingers are set up, this is more of a slasher type character. So, into that. Then, you can also have. So let's just put that for a body blow. Actually, I can go in for an elbow shot. All right. Einstein Jansom has subbed for 18 months. Yo, Einstein in the house. How you doing? I'm doing good, man. Thank you. Bald Bulldozer has subbed and has gifted. Kanger Banger has gifted a sub to Gamma Plex. Unexplained Soup has resubbed. Pandemus has cheered. Patrick 10. Thank you for the tips, Pandemus, on how to use YouTube. Where were you half an hour ago? Oh, you were there. You were right here telling me I wasn't paying attention. Patrick 10 has subbed. Tony Bologna, JTV, in the doghouse has cheered. Nothing like spending Thanksgiving in Canada. That's right. You guys celebrated early. Stone Cold Snake 316 has cheered as well. I have an art question. Go ahead and shoot. Snaffle Shambles. Queen City Amusements has cheered. Thank you. That was a while ago. Jester X, M. Friel, and Byron the Bulb, Comics and Ponies, Dracus, subbing, Past Mural. So my question was, what should I put in my portfolio to get a job at DC Marvel Image? 3 pages of your best panel-to-panel work. That's all you need. PJ Beiser, still tired from New York Comic Con. Yeah, I'm fighting off something. My son had it. A couple of our kids had it. A little congestion, but nothing major yet. Darth Lordy, looking forward to seeing you at Baltimore. Same here. Be cool. All right. False Light 88 has subbed. Kiwi Boy 3 has resubbed as well. All right. So. You know what? Maybe I was right. That foot goes there. Goes there. Okay. I'll start inking. Ryan Villain has subbed. Thank you very much. Stream. What happened to the stream? I think I've lost the stream. I must close the window. Never fear. All right, so let's just start with structure. And maybe look at the other bits of information reference I have, make sure that I have is correct. From, like, it basically fit. Using 3 points of different reference, if it looks pretty similar, I'm in pretty good shape, right? Pandemus. So the left and right keys don't advance it frame by frame. It just goes 5 seconds. So it's not getting me the clear. Just not getting me. Do this. I don't know, does this guy have a big horn or is it two triangular planes? Decision based on this reference. Let me see what else I've got here. Nope. Okay, it's a big horn. Someone give me some bits for making that decision. Thank you very much. I appreciate it. The thing is, these are not all straight. And here's a trick that I believe it was Wills Portasio taught me. In complex designs like this, if you don't know what's going on, just make it something. And I've also heard Scott Williams say the same thing, like, get pencils that are just too busy or smeared. You don't know exactly what it is that you're inking. Don't just put ink down. Make it into something. Pretend it's something, react to it, draw it, ink it. And work better. It'll actually become something. It's a 0.5. I feel like this is a little too thick. Switch pens after I do some big shapes, though. See you later, Jacob BRT21. You want to see my reference? This way. I'll show you. Ooh, references coming my way. Should probably just stop. But, so here's one. You guys can see that. It's a cartoony representation, but it's simple, right? It doesn't have any details, it just has the basic shapes, which is kind of what you need. And then the other one I'm working from is this side shot. The other one is this. So here's the other shot. I don't know if you guys can see this well at all. So that's what was tripping me out. Like, is his head a V? Is it a V shape like this with a dot in the center? Right. But I think it's more like this. And then there's like these two phalanges or whatever that phalanges stick out. What's throwing me is that these, from an angle, look like that. If you turn this thing, if you were to turn it sideways, it would look like that, right? So that's where I was getting a little caught up. So that's what I have there. So with these claws, again, not a slave to the reference per se, but I do want to be consistent. There's going to be a lot of black shapes and stuff like that in here. Yellow stripe there, so I'm going to make sure I get that represented. So just got to make it into something. Kenny Roberts, 84, had back surgery. Not gone that route yet. Recover. Get well soon, dude. I don't know you, but seem like a decent guy. Are you drawing the two or four-armed variant? I didn't realize that there were variants. I'm drawing the four-armed variant. I hope these two robots fight each other. I don't have a... Is anyone... is super familiar with Genlock? No? Mr. Raha99. Good to see you. Wolfie Poo. I get the reference and I'll be like, okay, we're closing in on 10:30, so I'm going to have to stop. But I am, you know what, I'm going to stream again later, because I do have to finish this tonight. But I have a birthday celebration to go to, so. For it later. But you can kind of see what's going on, right? Yes? So I'm thinking it would be what time is it now? It'll be late. Later tonight. I'll have word in the Discord channel. So let's thank our mods, Kirihiko and Crispy Egg Roll, for their support. I appreciate it. Join our Discord. We do a fun thing where we go and raid another stream, another creative. So we're going to do that now. Let's see if I can find somebody. Our mods are the people that kind of do the reference. Kiko to give me something. Thank you guys for tuning in. Let's see what next Sunday. Coming back from Baltimore. There might be a stream. If there is, it'll be in the evening again. Just because I'm traveling back Sunday morning. All right. So this is a thing where we basically drop in on someone who doesn't expect us to be there and shower them with some art love. So again, thank you guys for tuning in. I appreciate your support. We'll be on later tonight. My guess is around 7, well, probably 9-ish Pacific time, PM. And hopefully I'll see a bunch of you guys there. So thank you for tuning in. We're going to drop in on this person's art and check it out. Thanks.